Hey there, my name is Aaron Nace, and today we're gonna be using artificial intelligence to create a background for a portrait and then composite them together in Photoshop. We're starting off with this really cool portrait, and I like all this artistic effect. We have like interesting painterly shapes on our subject, and the background is just a white background. It's really not that interesting. So we're gonna head over to artificial intelligence to create something from scratch. Now for this, we're gonna be using Midjourney. So let's go ahead, check out their website and get started. So here we are with midjourney.com. You can go down to where it says get started on the bottom left here, and then there's documentation. But basically with this quick start guide, it basically just tells you to join the Discord server, okay? So there's a lot of tutorials out there on how to do this and getting started with it. But basically with Midjourney, there's a free version where anyone can join. And then there's a paid version where you kind of get your own dedicated service. So let's go ahead and check out the Discord server. So here we are in Discord. Now I'm on the Midjourney server and we can see there's information on like announcements and rules and welcome messages and things like that. But there's these rooms that are like a newbie room. Basically, it's like where you can type in your own prompt. Now, all you have to do is go right down here and you can hit the slash key. And then we're gonna go to imagine and then we're just gonna call it paint. So I'm just gonna say imagine paint and then it's gonna scroll all the way about down to the very, very bottom. And it's kind of like working on everyone's stuff at the same time. So if you scroll through, you can see what like hundreds and thousands of people are asking for. Now with this, like for me personally, I'm like, this is kind of annoying. I don't want to scroll through everyone's stuff to try to see my own thing. I get it. It's cool because it's free, but you're just going to be scrolling through a bunch of other people's work to try to find your own. So what I've actually done is paid for a Midjourney subscription. It's like, there's a couple different tiers. You can find information on that on their website. And when you pay for it, you get access to your own private messaging with the Midjourney server. So you're not gonna have to see anyone else's work and it works a little bit faster. So let's go ahead and show you what that looks like. But again, you don't have to pay for Midjourney. You can get this totally for free. Just in my opinion, the UI, the interface and like the actual interaction, just a little bit more annoying. But let's go ahead and check out the private messages within Midjourney. So I'm gonna go over here to my direct messages. There we go. And then here we have our Midjourney bot. So in this bot, here's where we're gonna type in, and this is like my own private conversation with Midjourney basically. So I'm gonna just hit the slash key. I'm gonna hit imagine, and then I'm gonna paste in a prompt. We're just gonna say something like colorful geometric 2D rectangles and triangles watercolor on a white background and hit enter. And then it starts working. Obviously this is artificial intelligence. It's not completely like immediate, but it starts working on the background. Let's go ahead and do one more. So we're gonna type in, there we go. We're gonna type in imagine. I'm gonna type in colorful shapes, acrylic. Is that how you spell acrylic? Paint on white background geometric. There we go. And let's hit enter on that. And you, as you can see, it kind of starts working. Now, the way that Midjourney works is it creates iterations. So like we can see it's actually like working in real time. You can see here it's 31%, now it's 46%, and it just kind of keeps on going and going and going and kind of like refining those results. Now, once you find something you're happy with, you can upscale it and actually get a higher resolution of any of these results. So the prompts are completely done. Now let's check it out. We actually have four different images that it outputs with each of them. I like this one here on the top right. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna say U2, which stands for upscale. It's gonna upscale version 2. And then you can also tell it, I want it to create a couple variations of that version. So I'm gonna hit V2 as well. So it's gonna upscale that one and it's gonna give me some variations. Now let's check the other one where I said colorful shapes, acrylic paint on white background. This is really cool, right? I think this one actually would work pretty well. So let's hit U for upscale number 2, and then I'm gonna hit V for version 2. It should create a couple different versions based on that as well. So the whole deal with artificial intelligence is it's kind of like a conversation. It gives you a result and then you say like, I like this, let's do a little bit more of it. And then you can kind of keep going and refining until you find something you really like. So just a second ago, remember we had this image and I said, I like this one on the top right. So I told it to make an upscale version of 2 and then make a couple variations of 2 as well. So let's go ahead and scale down to the upscaled version. And here it is, just click on it. There we go. We can just right click. I'm going to hit copy image. And then we're just going to jump into Photoshop. I'm going to create a new layer and hit paste. You can see it's a little bit on the small side, but we can scale that up. Let's go back into Discord and see what we've got here. This is our upscaled resolution of this other one. So we're going to go ahead and click on this. I'm going to right click and say copy image. We're going to go back into Photoshop, create a new layer and hit paste on that. There we go. And then we can see, ooh, we've got a couple more variations based on that. And that's what I asked it to do. So I'm going to go ahead and say upscale version 2 on this one as well. And as you can see, you can kind of go back and forth to this as many times as you like. Keep in mind, I'm using like geometric shapes and artistic and like colorful on a white background, because that's kind of what we have with our original portrait. And I wanted something that's going to match the like tone and feel of that portrait. So here's our last one. Let's go ahead and click on this. I'm going to right click and we're going to go to copy image and then get back into Photoshop. We're going to create a new layer and I'm going to hit paste. So we have all three of these different options that we can use, 1, 2, and 3. Now, of course, you could just create these until you literally ran out of time. You just do it forever. But what we're gonna do now is upscale this. And again, we're gonna be using artificial intelligence to do that. So here we are in Photoshop. Now, I really like this image here. I think it's gonna work really well with the shapes that we have on our subject. So let's go ahead and click on this layer. Now we're gonna go to our filter dialog down to where it says neural filters. Neural filters, and then we have this new filter from Photoshop that's called Super Zoom. It's incredibly cool. Let's go ahead and turn that on. And then here where it says zoom image, we just hit this plus icon a few different times. So we're gonna go to 4x. This is gonna get larger and then it's gonna use artificial intelligence to fill in gaps in information. So although the output from Midjourney is a little bit limited, basically it's like 1024 by 1024 pixels, you can then use this super zoom to scale it up even more and you're gonna get a high resolution image that you can then combine with your images. It's done processing. We're gonna go ahead and where it says output, I'm gonna choose new layer and let's go ahead and hit okay. And as you can see, boom, look at that. Beautiful and way larger. There's the original one. Boop, 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 tiny, tiny little. And here we go. This is the new output. So now it's time for some fun. We're just gonna take all those other ones and make them invisible for now. So we're gonna put this with our subject. This is gonna be so much fun. Let's go ahead and make this invisible for now. Here on our background layer, we're just gonna go ahead and double click where it says background because it has this little chain lock on it right now. Basically, it's locked. You can't make a layer mask on it. Just double click on it and hit okay. Now it's a regular layer and I can do a layer mask. So let's go up to select. We're gonna go down to where it says subject, select subject. This is just an artificial intelligence filled tutorial. Loving it. So our subject is selected. You can see it's not perfect. So we always wanna go to select and then down to select and mask. Super important. Select and mask. And then you can use these brushes over here to kind of like refine. Basically, I'm just like telling it where to include. So we're just gonna paint over and say, yep, that's actually her face. I know it just looks like a green blob, but it's paint on her face. Okay, and then for the hair, this like really doesn't look good over here, but this is our refine edge brush right over here. It looks like a brush entering a scary witch's hand. Okay, so then we just paint over here. And you can see it's gonna refine this much, much better. Let's go ahead, we're just gonna paint it over here. And we're gonna get a lot more information than we would have. There we go, you can see it's actually including the hair. And you can just take your color here and you can like change your opacity to see like what is masked and what is not masked. All right, let's go ahead and bring it over here and refine this edge. Oh, this is not working very well actually. Let's go out to our refine mode. Let's go to color aware. There we go. And let's see how this is working. All right, that's working a little bit better with the color mode selected. I had object mode selected and it was like not really working that well, to be honest. But hey, look, we're learning together and that's part of the fun. There we go. Color aware refine mode. If you ever find your refine edge brush just like is not working well, just change your mode and you should be good. All right, I think this is looking pretty good. Like we're all in all like pretty much there. Is that her? Maybe we'll just mask that out later. Okay, all in all, this looks pretty good. You can change your opacity like to see your before and after, but like this is a pretty good result. Much better than we got like straight out of camera. So let's go ahead and just bring this up so you can actually see it. We're gonna hit okay. Well, actually before we do that, sorry, scroll all the way down to the bottom where it says output to, You can choose a selection here, but I already know I want this to be a layer mask, so we're just gonna click there and go to layer mask and hit okay. Boom. So now our subject is cut out from the background. How awesome is this? So like literally all we have to do now, I'm just gonna bring my subject up to the top of my layer stack. So just bring her way up there, click and drag all the way to the top. And then we just make this new background visible behind her. This is like the background that we made using artificial intelligence. There we go. So I'm gonna hit Control or Command T. We're gonna scale this up a little bit more. Of course, you could use Super Zoom again if you wanted to, but that is looking, oh, this is her arm down there. I was like, what is that detail down there? It's her arm. Okay, now that looks pretty cool. I've got like the left-hand side, and of course you could use two separate images. What I'm gonna do, because like most of it's hidden, I'm gonna hit Control or Command J. That just duplicates my layer. And then we're just gonna move this over to the right-hand side so I can use like the rest of it. And then of course, it's just like a graphic type image, right? So if you hit Control or Command T, I'm gonna bring my little control point right over there. If you don't see your control point, by the way, so Control or Command T, here's a cool tip. Control or Command T, this little control point allows like, if you're gonna rotate or transform, it'll rotate around this point. But if you don't see that, because it's actually not turned on by default, you gotta go all the way up here to this checkbox here, make sure that's checked on, and then here you can actually choose where you want it. You could be like top right, middle center, there we go. But you can just kind of like click and move it wherever you want. And then if I go up here to my rotation controls, which is right here, there we go. You can just click, like you could type in a number there. Like you could type in like 90, boom, and it'll rotate 90 degrees. But what I usually do is just click on this icon and just like drag this to the left or the right. There we go. Now we can kind of see how it goes. And if you go shift, it just goes faster. So I'm just kind of like doing this to be like, I don't know, what do I want? That looks kind of cool right there, right? Boom. And then it's like obviously visible on the left-hand side. So we're just gonna put a layer mask on that. Both B for, just click on your layer mask icon, which is right here. And then I can use my lasso tool, L for the lasso tool. Just make a super quick selection. And then here on the layer mask, we're gonna go to edit, down here to fill. There we go. And we're just gonna say fill that with black. Perfect. So there we go. We've got this on the left and the right. So check this out, man. Like, what a crazy time, like world we're living in. Like, honestly, this is so cool because we've got this really interesting portrait here. What I'm gonna maybe move this up a little bit. Let's click on the chain link to unlink the layer and the layer mask so I can move them independently. Maybe I'll just move that like right over there. Like, how amazingly cool is that? Let's just group those together, turn that off and on. Like, this is our original image. And then here's what we have, like with artificial intelligence, bringing this all together. And like, I told it what to do because I wanted it to match this portrait. And in my opinion, it matches it really well. And like, boom, we have an amazingly cool portrait composite with a much more interesting background than it was originally, just a plain white. Thanks so much for watching today's video. Hit that big thumbs up if you enjoy this. Click that subscribe button. We'll send you more free Photoshop tutorials. You know what to do. Just do it. Thanks again. I'll flirt you later. Bye, everyone. Just do it. Just do it already. You know what to do. I'm not even gonna tell you what it is. Just do it. Artificial intelligence is taking over my life. Pretty soon, it's not even gonna be me as a real person. You're just gonna be watching a computer-generated version of me, but you might think it's real. But it's not gonna do cool stuff like this, because it doesn't know how. Ah!